Hi, this is Sriyank Siddhartha and welcome to another video on Kotlin programming. So in this one video, I'm going to talk about what is backing field in Kotlin. Now remember, backing field and backing property are two different concepts in Kotlin. So if you want to learn about what is backing property in Kotlin, then I have a separate video of that. The link for that is in description, please check it out. And of course, before you start this video, if you are new, then please subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up. So let us understand backing field with an example. Suppose we have a class human. And inside this class, we have a property of age. Now from the basics of Kotlin, we know that for every property which we create inside a class, a default getter and setter is internally created. Right? So we don't have to explicitly declare its getter and setter. But if you want to customize its getter and setter, then you need to declare them and write code within them. So let's customize its getter first. So here we have the getter, then we have some custom code, and finally we return something. Now this statement over here, if executed, will throw StackOverflow exception. Because in Kotlin, within your getter or setter, you cannot access the property by using the property name itself. For example, here you cannot use age property within its own getter. If you use it this way, then this $age will execute its own getter over here, and our code will enter into infinite recursion, resulting in StackOverflow exception. So what is the solution for this? Well, to avoid this exception for this purpose, we make use of backing field in Kotlin. So instead of using the property name such as age, you just need to replace it by field keyword. So instead of this statement, you can use this statement. And that's it. Your problem will be solved. So this field is basically a keyword, which stores the value of age property in memory. So this field is nothing, but it is known as backing field in Kotlin. And this is what this video is all about. Quite simple, isn't it? Then finally, this return statement, return field, will return the current value of age property. Great, isn't it? Now the same principle applies for custom setter as well. Within this, we can write some code, such as some if condition. Then we can use this backing field, which represents nothing but the age property itself. So this assigns the incoming value to the age by using field equal to value. And of course, you cannot use this statement as it will throw an exception. Perfect. Now you can execute this entire program in a very normal way, so nothing changes in that part. For example, within your main function, we can create human instance, then execute this code. So this statement will execute the setter method, which is present over here, and pass the value of 54, which will fall in this value parameter over here. Then this statement will execute the getter method, which is present over here. And we have a print line inside it. So due to this print statement, in the output, we get this result. So nothing changes when you want to execute the code which uses backing field in Kotlin. Now moving on, you should also note that the backing field is not generated by Kotlin unless it is required in your code. So what does that mean? Let us take an example. So here in this case, internally, Kotlin will generate backing field code for you, which you can verify by looking at its bytecode. Because in its getter, we are trying to access the property itself by using the field keyword, right? But suppose we have one more property, where we don't need any custom getter or setter to access the property itself. Then for this case, no backing field will be generated by Kotlin internally. So let's take one more example. Here in this case, we have a Boolean property is old, which returns a Boolean value from its custom getter. But here as well, the backing field won't be generated. Because though it has a custom getter, but we are not trying to access the property itself within this getter function, right? We are only trying to access another property such as age, but not the property itself. So that is why no backing field will be generated, since no field keyword is being used at present. So remember, backing field is not dependent on the custom getter or setter. It is only dependent on whether you are trying to use the property itself or not within these getter or setter. So please note this. This is very important. So now, let us sum up what we have learned so far, just to make things more clear. So, backing field is represented by the field keyword. It just stores the value of its own property and nothing else. It is used because usage of property name within the getter or setter throws Stack Overflow exception. The backing field is generated by Kotlin internally only when it is used in code. So if you don't use it, Kotlin won't generate it. You can even verify that by decompiling the code itself. Now, one last important point to note is that backing field can only be used within getter or setter. That is, you cannot use it in any other custom method other than these getters and setters. So please note this point. I haven't shown you the example of this point in this video until now. Fine. So this was a very short video on Kotlin backing field. So how was the video? Do let me know in the comment box below. And if you want more such videos on this programming languages, then do subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video, then give this video a big thumbs up. So this is Sriyank Siddhartha signing off. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.